lovely to attend the chapter. We've been talking to each other, but today we've got a time of extended worship. In our new rhythm of how we do church together on Sundays, the first Sunday of the month is always going to be an all major or a messy. The second Sunday is always going to be a communion service. The third one will always be a cafe style service. And the fourth one is going to be an extended time of worship. And that's from feedback that we received during the lockdown. But many of you really appreciated hearing a slightly extended song worship set. So today, we are joined on the platform by the fabulous Ben, Theo and Nadia, and they are going to lead us in an extended time. So we want you to feel comfortable to stand or sit, however that looks and works for you. There's no rules to that. You do what you feel is right for you in the moment as we worship together. Some of you will notice that Hannah isn't here this morning. Hannah has already made her way into Bournemouth because it is Davinia's induction service today at Iford Baptist Church. Now, Iford Baptist Church is about as big as this platform, so it wasn't possible for us all to take a road trip just yet because of social distancing. But if you go onto YouTube at 3:30 this afternoon and you put in the box Iford Baptist Church, you will find the link to the stream, and they'll be streaming it for those of us that can't make it. So that's Iford, I-F-O-R-D, Baptist Church. It's really easy to find. If you're on social media, I posted out the link yesterday. Let's worship together some words as we come together this morning. Come with what you have. For you who grieve this day, know that you were invited to bring the broken pieces of your heart. Come with what you have. For you who come with gladness, know that your melody will find harmony. Come with what you have. For you weighed down by too many shoulds and what ifs, know that here you may lay down your burdens. Come with what you have. For you who have the answers, know that new questions today will come. And come with what you have. For you who are seeking, know that your questions are safe here in the presence of God. Friends, let's worship together.
The Lord, our God and King, His love endures forever. For He is good, He is above all things. His love endures forever. Sing praise, sing praise, sing praise. Thank you.
Oh, Yes, Lord, we live in an uncertain world. We live in a scared and frightened world. But we know that no matter what happens, no matter where we are, no matter what is going on, you are stronger. Your love is stronger. Your power is stronger than anything in this world. And we just want to stand here today and give you our hearts, and we ask that you would fill us with your love today. That you would be here in this place, that we feel your spirit moving in us. That you'd lift us out of the weeks we've had. And just let us look upon your face.
I worship your holy name.
the next one's definitely one. If the kids want to come off and join in with the instruments, this one should be absolutely up their street. And if anyone knows the actions, feel free to join in. Some of us are big and tall, some of us are very small, some of us are pink and some like blue. Some of us like reading books, some of us like feeding ducks. That's because we're different, me and you. The color
I'm
Baptism is always an option. There is a lovely baptismal pool here, and I've not got to use it yet, So, you know, anyone wants to have a go, let's have a chat about that. There's just a few practical business things. A few people have been quite out of the loop of church over lockdown because we haven't had permission to contact them. GDPR is a big thing, and churches are getting into trouble all over the land for contacting people that they shouldn't be and people who've asked not to be contacted. So we have a consent form for us to contact you. Now this became quite apparent when someone, our first week back, asked me where Ian was. Some of you will remember, Ian was the minister here, and he's been gone quite a while now, and I've been here quite a while now, but they've been out of the loop because we didn't have permission to contact them, and so they weren't on any of the lists for the information. So there's one of those forms. The other form I've got in my hand is around our children's and youth work. So our kids' Sunday ministry is coming back next month, so it'll be on the second and fourth Sunday of the month. We are going to be intergenerational for half the month, and now have some time out, half the month. But we can't have our children with us unless we've got a consent form that gives us things like their dates of birth, so we can work out ratios of where they're going, allergies, that kind of thing. It's important for us to know and how to get prepared. So, if we don't have forms for your children and you'd like them to join in 2 weeks' time, I can give you a copy of that form. Next week is Messy Harvest, and so we'll be celebrating harvest in a messy style as one church. I know that previously, Messy Church has meant the children go out and the adults stay here for adults' church. And messy church happens out there. We're no longer doing that, friends. We can all be messy, and we can all learn from one another. And many of our children and youth need to have older spiritual friends in their lives. We don't want to segregate them. You've seen this morning, our worship leaders are young. They can be young, and the Holy Spirit moves in all humans. So we want to worship together. We'll do that in a messy style. We don't quite know what that will look like with COVID, so we're going to bear with us, but we'll figure it out. And if you'd like to bring any donations, we'll be collecting for the food bank. So if we have your contact details and you're on the email list, you will know the big list of things that we are looking for. If you are not on that list, and so you don't get those details, today's a good day to fill in the form, and we can make sure that you have them. And then next Sunday in the evening, over at St Albans, one of our partner churches, they are hosting a supper and Thanksgiving at 6 o'clock. And you are all warmly welcome to attend. I'll be there. So if you want someone to sit with and join in with, let me know. I think that's it for notices. I'm looking around in case anyone's got anything else. Fabulous. Well, Graham is going to come and share God's word with us this morning, but I get the pleasure of reading to you. So I'm reading from 1 John 4, verses 7 to 18. If you've got your phone with you, it's got a Bible app on it, now's time to get it out. If you've got a paper Bible, brilliant. How blessed are you? Let's read together. That's 1 John 4, 7 to 18, and it says this. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. This is how God shows love amongst us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love. This is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as an anointing sacrifice, atoning sacrifice for us. Dear friends, since God loved us, so also ought we to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us, and his love is made complete in us. This is how we know that we live in him and he in us. He has given us his Spirit, and we have seen and testified that the Father has sent his Son to be the Saviour of the world. If anyone acknowledges that Jesus is the Son of God, God lives in them, and they in God. And so we know and rely on the love God has for us. God is love. Whoever lives in love lives in God and God in them. This is how love is made complete among us, so that we will have confidence on the day of judgment. In this world, we are like Jesus. There is no fear in love, but perfect love drives out fear, because fear has to do with punishment. The one who fears is not made perfect in love. Amen. Ben, could you do me a favour? Could you pray for Graham while I just sort this lectern out, because it's going to disappear? Graham, come on up, and Ben will pray for you while I make sure your lectern is tight.
Father God, we pray that you would work through your servant Graham. We pray that you would inspire him, that you would breathe your words into him, that you would give him your word for this church, for this family today. And we pray that you would bless the words that he prepares to bring to us, that you'd open our hearts and prepare us to hear. In Jesus' name. Amen.
God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. We sang that in one of the songs. Did you know that you're special to God and he loves each one of us? Love is the most powerful thing. This morning's not so much a sermon. In part, it's a testimony. Parents, do you love your children? Silly question, isn't it? Of course you do. Grandparents, do you love your grandchildren? Yeah, with a passion. Be a grandparent. And you'd do anything for them. And I believe you'd even give your life for them if that was necessary. Let's hope that never will be. In Deuteronomy 5, we get the commandments, all about the commandments. But it's not just about the commandments. Commandments are there not to be, you know, iron-fisted things. They're there so that we might live in harmony. And Moses said, impress them on your children. Talk about them when you're together. And you know what you do, so I don't think that's a good idea. It might be good to do it this way. Isn't that correct? Harmony. They're there so that we may teach our children and ourselves to live in harmony. Now, when I've talked to some people, or had the opportunity to, you get that reply, well, I'm not religious. What do you say to that? You know what I say? Anyone guess? I say, well, I'm not religious either. Because God is not about religion. Christianity is not about religion. It's about relationship. A relationship with God together. A loving relationship with God together. So it's not about religion. Doing stuff. It's not about status. It's about relationship with God. A long, long time ago, when I was nearly a teenager, just above it, three of us from here were invited from the church in Penge to go on a youth holiday with their young people. And it was a time when the Spirit began to moving in the gifts, and tongues was very much in conversation. And these young people, teenagers, 14, 15, whatever, had got it into their head that if you didn't speak in tongues, you weren't a proper Christian. I said, what foolishness is that? Speaking in tongues is a gift of God if you're already a Christian. about relationship, not about what I can do or what I can do for God. When my father died, it was a bit traumatic. My mum found out, your dad doesn't look well, he looks white, he's not moving. So I rushed down the corner, fortunately I was running down the corner, and I remember trying to resuscitate him with a neighbour who was a nurse, unsuccessfully. And that night I couldn't really sleep very well. I didn't know, really know if my dad believed anything. The only time the church was mentioned, he used to complain about the vicar in the war, that all he was interested in was getting money for the church roof when people were losing their homes. So I was a bit unsettled, and I couldn't sleep that night, so I got up early and I went for a walk. And I was going through a mission. And it was amazing. I don't know if this is an event that happens every morning, because I'm talking about 2:30 in the morning. It's quite light. And the starlings were filling the trees in the centre of the mission. Have you ever been to Leicester Square and heard the starlings do that in the evening? Very loud. And it was like God was saying to me, listen, this is my choir, rejoicing in the new day that is coming. And I walked through that and went up to Beehive Bridge, which is the railway bridge north of Three Kings Peace. And I stood there, interesting, a police car came driving up very slowly, and it slowed down and came to the top of the bridge. And I looked around and acknowledged them, and they happily went away. I think they thought I was going to jump. But I stood there and I was just looking along the lateral railway. It was going dead straight until it came to a point. And you know, the Lord spoke to me. There was a voice in the back of my mind. I am the Alpha, I am the Omega, I am the beginning and the end. All things are under my control. And he simply said, leave it with me. It's with me now. And I just got peace and went on and carried on with my life. God is always with us. Did you know that? There was another time many years ago, I'd had cardio surgery and we went away for a weekend. I wasn't sure where life was going for me. I wasn't sure what was going to happen next. We had a B&B in Edmonton, in Suffolk. I don't know if anyone has ever been there. Nice place to visit. And opposite the B&B was this huge, it looked like a college with a massive garden. And the guy that owned the B&B said, no, this is a Christian conference centre and the public are allowed to go in the garden. So we went after them, just went in the garden, had a look round. And there was a drive leading up to the house, a very wide pathway. And it was marked with 12 signs of the cross, you know, when Jesus went,
carried his cross.
Oh, that meant. And there was a tree and a bench, and I thought I'd have a sit down. It was very unkempt. It wasn't one of these gardens like you go and see at Chelsea. And Irene wandered off on her own to have a look around, and I just sat there. And I had an experience that I never had before, and I've never had since. And it was just amazing. It was as though there was a heaviness that came down. It was as though there was a presence. I can't really describe it, to be honest. I just sat there, and I just felt as though I was being held. I just felt I was being held, and I was secure. And it was as though God said to me, I've got you. I've got you. It's okay. I've never forgotten that. I never will. Brothers and sisters, God's love is very, very powerful. In the reading this morning, it said, let us love one another. Whoever lives in love lives in God and God in him. We love because he first loved us and he still loves us. Love is not just a feeling. The world has got no idea what love is. In fact, the world is, seems to me at the moment, sadly full of hope. Love is not just a feeling, it's an attitude and it's involved action. We know that Scripture says, Jesus said, love your neighbour. He also said in Matthew 5, love your enemy and love those who persecute you. He said, if your enemy is hungry, what did he say? Feed him. If he is thirsty, give him a drink. It's not our job to judge. That's God's prerogative. Ours is to pray for their redemption and to be there for those who really need. There are many ways to give to the needy and to serve the needy. One is food bank, which we've just taken on. That's great. I've had challenges, I don't know about you, you walk along the street if you go up to London and there are people begging everywhere. And God had challenged me on that, because there's very often a guy sitting outside Tesco's as I walk up to get the morning paper. And a couple of times I've walked past, and it's as though God has said, did you see him? And I felt very bad about that, because sometimes you don't know these guys and women are genuine or not, especially if you go to London. So I just felt I had to go back and give him something. It's a challenge, isn't it? There are so many of them these days. But love is doing. Romans, it says, bless those who persecute you. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Be willing to associate with people of low position, people that are poor, people that are in need, people that are in trouble, and live in peace with everyone. Even the awkward neighbour. I've had a couple of those, and not so long ago either. And it's very difficult when the neighbour does something, and you know they're not supposed to do that, or put something there which causes problems. And there's no way you can solve that practically. You just have to put up with it. And you've still got to be polite. Polite and to treat them with respect. It's difficult. Difficult. But God can give you that power to do that. Even with an awkward neighbour. Anyone had an awkward neighbour? Nobody. We all get it wrong sometimes. We all do things wrong. But we have a loving Father who forgives us if we're truly repentant and sorry. He wipes the slate clean and he remembers it one more. I'm going to read a few verses from Corinthians as I end. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child, thought like a child, reasoned like a child, but when I became a man, I put away childish things, put them behind me. And now, I only see but a poor reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, but I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is, love. God is love. Praise his name. I'm going to read a hymn. I think, is that allowed to read a hymn from the Baptist hymn book? I don't know about you, but if you've got a Baptist hymn book, I'll borrow this one. They're like prayers, poetry, prayers. Very useful sometimes when you're sitting with the Lord. And this is one I like very much, I've known for years. I'm not going to sing it. If you want to close your eyes and just meditate upon it, that's fine. O love that will not let me go, I rest my weary soul in thee. I give thee back the life I owe. Within thine ocean depths its flow, may richer, fuller be. O light that followest all my way, I yield my flickering torch to thee. My heart restores its borrowed ray, within the sunshine's blaze its day, may brighter, fairer be. O joy that seeks me through pain, I cannot close my heart to thee. I trace the rainbow through the rain and feel the promise is not vain, that morn shall tearless be. O cross that lifts up my head, I dare not ask to fly from thee. I lay in dust life's glory dead, and from the ground where blossoms red, life that shall endless be. Father, we thank you that you love us. We thank you for sending Jesus to us. Lord, we pray that your kingdom will come on. It will come on earth. Lord, we thank you for our daily provision. And we ask that we may have the strength against temptation. Lord, you are holy. You are from everlasting to everlasting. And we give you our lives that we may love not only you, but all who you have made. In Jesus' name. Amen.
We're just going to sing one final song, so if you'd like to stand if you're able.
The Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he would give his only Son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing love, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which by the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon the cross, my guilt upon his shoulder, a shame.
Steadfast love, guide you until we can worship again together.